Did you know your brain is always on, working 24/7, even as you sleep? It controls the way you think, feel, and behave as a person. And what you eat has a definite influence on brain health, says a 2010 study on the effects of nutrients on brain function. Progressive brain disorders like dementia have become a massive problem, and they begin years before any symptoms even show up. And it's because of this that most people take brain health for granted. But think of it this way. If you had a shiny new car, you wouldn't run it on substandard gas, would you? Yet so many of us choose to fuel our brains with low-quality foods, and that begs the question. Which everyday foods are harming your brain, and what happens when you eat them? That's what you're going to find out in today's video. Get ready as we count down the 15 worst foods for your brain. Not only that, but you'll also discover a quick way to turn one of these worst foods into a healthy treat. A breakfast staple you need to avoid at all costs. A healthy seafood that isn't actually great for you. Now, before we jump into things, please don't forget to like the video and subscribe to this channel. That way you can view our other brain-related health videos at your leisure. And click that bell so you're the first to know when we release new content each week. Plus, make sure to keep watching as we'll also give you an important free gift. This gift will help you maximize the potential of your brain. Now, let's begin the countdown on the 15 worst foods for your brain. Number 15, cured meat. Did you know that humans have been curing meat as far back as 3000 BC? Few can resist the deep flavors and soft textures of these cold cuts on the charcuterie board. What's your favorite? Salami, prosciutto, pastrami, pepperoni, or Spanish chorizo, perhaps? But there's a darker side to these tasty cuts that everyone should know about. At best, binging on cured meats can cause brain fog soon after eating. The high salt content forces your kidneys to create excess urine. That, in turn, causes your body to dehydrate, which leads to cognitive decline. More worrying is that a 2018 study found that nitrates, chemicals used to cure some meats, may cause an abnormal elevated mood state called mania. And 2020 research looked at the potential harm from regular processed meat consumption. The findings suggest it increases the risk of developing incident dementia. Why not do your brain a favor and enjoy cured meats only as an occasional treat? Number 14, full-fat cheese. Cheese is a much-loved food globally, boasting over 2,000 varieties. Who can resist cheddar, camembert, blue, mozzarella, and the sweet, nutty taste of Swiss? Cheese, in most forms, is a highly nutritious food. It has protein, calcium, fats, vitamins, essential minerals, and milk nutrients. But if it's so nutritious, versatile, and delicious, then why is it on the list of worst foods for brain health? Well, those cheesy textures so many of us relish are laden with saturated fat. A little saturated fat is not a bad thing, but too much most certainly is. See, saturated fats change gut microbiota or gut flora, but not in a good way. Evidence suggests that alterations to gut microbiota can affect brain health and behavior. That includes changes to memory function, less cognitive flexibility, and anxiety. But don't take cheeses off the menu just yet, because there's some good news too. Cheese, in moderation, is more healthy than harmful. And it gets even better. Researchers at Iowa State University found that a bit of cheese with red wine is, wait for it, beneficial to brain health. Early research suggests it may even prevent cognitive decline as people age. The next worst food for brain health has little to celebrate, so stay tuned for that. Number 13, white sliced bread. Bread is one of the world's favorite go-to foods and has been for thousands of years. It's portable, tastes great with fillings, and can hold some nutritional value. Did you know that Americans eat a staggering 300 million sandwiches every single day? And the British munch their way through 9 million loaves a day for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. It's a similar story in other countries, so bread is here to stay. But it's not all equal. Beware of prepackaged, sliced white bread. Why? Because it's a high glycemic index, or GI, food made from processed carbohydrates. Refined carbs are easy to eat and quick to digest, but with very little nutritional value and a lack of fiber. Also, white processed bread causes blood glucose to spike and fall erratically. That can drain you of energy, trigger mood swings, and cause brain fog. Studies also suggest that refined carbs may increase the risk of Alzheimer's disease, especially in those genetically prone to the condition. Moreover, processed bread and other white foods like pasta, potatoes, and white rice contribute to weight gain and health complications associated with obesity. So next time you're shopping for bread, choose whole wheat instead. It has fiber, more nutrition, and fewer calories than those white sliced loaves. Number 12, margarine. Margarine was not the invention of an enthusiastic cook or chef. A French chemist formulated the new chemical spread from a lab in 1869. Margarine quickly became a popular and cheaper alternative to real butter in the 1970s. But it isn't butter, not even close, and it's not a healthy alternative. The problem with margarine is that it contains harmful trans fats, and we now know that long-term consumption of trans fats can harm brain function. Margarine is also considered a killer food. We'll get to that in a minute, but first, researchers at the University of California ran a study on male volunteers under 45. The men all regularly consumed foods high in trans fats. The results will astound you. All men showed a drop in memory function, bad moods, and some aggressive behavior. Another study published in the journal Neurology revealed more disturbing results. It found a possible link between the trans fat oleic acid and dementia in older adults. There are enough reasons to avoid margarine, but there's more. Harvard researchers say the trans fat in margarine, along with other processed foods, is killing thousands with heart disease. Trans fats raise your bad LDL cholesterol while lowering your good HDL cholesterol. That results in a buildup of cholesterol in your arteries, leading to heart attack and stroke. Be good to yourself and welcome butter back into your life. Number 11, alcoholic beverages. For most people, alcohol is a pleasant social drink enjoyed in moderation. It helps you to relax, let your hair down, and interact easier with others. Or at least it used to. Alcohol now causes 2.8 million premature deaths globally each year. And a large study published in The Lancet suggests alcohol intake is on the rise. In fact, global alcohol consumption has increased by a staggering 70% since 1990. Why does this matter? Because alcohol is a toxin, and too much of it changes how your brain functions. The immediate effects of drinking to excess are obvious. It reduces reaction time, impairs memory, blurs vision, and slurs speech. But drinking too much too often can result in serious diseases. That includes permanent alcohol-related brain damage and damage to your nervous system. See, alcohol can travel through your blood-brain barrier that directly affects the brain's neurons. And because it's toxic, it can damage or even kill your vital nerve cells. Remember, having too much alcohol may give you temporary fun, but it also brings permanent consequences. Number 10, donuts. Donuts, the chewy, tasty, high-carb, high-fat, sugary snack loved around the world. There are more than 10 billion of these sticky treats made every year in the US alone. The mix of fats, carbs, and sugar is what makes them so irresistible and Moorish. Researchers at Yale University say this type of food triggers the brain's reward center, but there are good reasons to put that donut down and walk away. Growing evidence suggests sugary, high-processed foods like donuts are bad for your brain. They may trigger memory loss and even brain-altering dementia, and Alzheimer's disease begins when there's too much sugar on your brain. It all starts by over-consuming sugar and under-consuming healthy fats, which can eventually lead to diabetes. Diabesity is a term used to describe diabetes caused by excess weight or obesity. The condition leads to inflammation that causes premature brain aging. Number 9, canned tuna. Food experts have always told you to eat more fish, but now the advice is changing. While canned tuna has been a staple in kitchens around the world for a long time, there is a trade-off to this convenience. Sure, this low-calorie, protein-packed fish is delicious and inexpensive, and it's also an excellent source of omega-3 fatty acids. Not to mention that canned tuna can sit in your food cupboard for years before it goes bad, but there's a problem. Canned tuna also contains traces of the heavy metal mercury. It's not the tins, but the flesh of the fish that gets contaminated from polluted waters. Tuna also eats other mercury-contaminated fish as part of its diet, which adds to the problem. Seriously, you want to do everything you can to keep mercury off the dinner plate. Studies confirm that mercury toxicity changes your central nervous system. It can also harm your lungs, kidneys, digestive, and immune systems. And the potential consequences to brain health are dire. Some of those include fatigue, irritability, headaches, cognitive loss, and hallucinations. Mercury toxicity can even lead to death in extreme cases. Seafood should be part of your healthy diet, but you might want to skip the canned tuna. Instead, consider canned smoked trout, canned sardines, or canned salmon. Salmon may have slight traces of mercury, but it's much lower than tuna. Before we continue with our countdown, it's time to reveal your free gift. Brain Food Secrets, the 15 worst and best foods for your brain. Discover the foods that can enhance mental focus, boost mood, ease depression, and much more. Click the link in the description below to grab your free copy now. Now, onto our list. Number 8, French fries. Who doesn't love a serving of hot, seasoned French fries? According to the Journal of Nutrition, they're the most eaten hot veggie for kids 2 to 4 years. How about you? Were you weaned onto fries as a toddler? And did you find the hot snack impossible to resist as an adult? Well, now might be a good time to wean yourself off the fries, or at least cut back. It's not the potato, but the oil used to cook them that causes so much concern. A 10-year study of 1,600 older adults in Japan revealed shocking results. It looked at the levels of industrial trans fats in the volunteers' blood, and those with the highest amounts had little to celebrate. These folks were around 75% more likely to develop Alzheimer's or dementia. The American Journal of Clinical Nutrition published an alarming study. It looked at the relationship between fried potato consumption and mortality. Eating French fries more than twice a week could double your risk of premature death. Again, the main culprit was not the potato, but the oils used to fry them. Do you question the fats used to cook food? It might not say trans fats on the label, but that doesn't mean it's absent. Food manufacturers often hide this dangerous fat by other names. Look for shortening and partially hydrogenated oil or fat on the ingredients list. Or take control by making healthier homemade fries instead, and bake, don't fry. Number 7, sugary drinks. Scientists agree, sugary drinks have a definite link to accelerated brain aging. The worst culprits are beverages that contain brain-damaging fructose or fruit sugar. Researchers looked at data from the ongoing Framingham Heart Study, specifically at people who often drank sugary beverages. They had poorer memory compared to those who didn't consume sweetened drinks. But that's not all. They also had reduced brain volume overall and a smaller hippocampus, the area of your brain needed for memory and learning. So the solution is to switch to diet sodas, right? Not so fast. A follow-up study tracked people who regularly drank diet soft drinks. This group was 3 times more likely to develop dementia or suffer a stroke. It seems that artificially sweetened drinks raise cardiometabolic risk factors in some people. Scientists agree they need to run more studies to decide the actual causes. Also, they did not single out any artificial sweetener, but the research continues. Even so, there's one widely used artificial sweetener that remains highly controversial, which is the next one on our list. Number 6, aspartame. Some artificial sweeteners can be harmful to your body and brain, and aspartame is the most controversial of them all. It's 200 times sweeter than table sugar. So what's all the fuss about? Well, over 100 studies to date support its safety for use in food and drinks, but early suspicions linked aspartame consumption to brain cancer. The pro camp argued that the initial research was inadequate and flawed, so the experts dismissed it. Those on the side of the counter argument disagree. They also suggest that regular consumption of aspartame causes several other brain conditions. Some of those include anxiety, depression, headache, seizures, and memory loss. Others imply a link with shooting pains, blindness, birth defects, and even death. A 2014 study examined the effects of aspartame on volunteers over 8 days. Researchers divide the groups into high and low aspartame diets. Those on the high aspartame diet displayed more irritability. They also showed greater signs of depression, and they performed worse on spatial orientation tests. Despite those against its approval, aspartame is still widely used as a sugar alternative in many foods and drinks. You can find it in diet sodas, low-calorie fruit juices, and sugarless candy. It's also in sugar-free ice cream, gum, yogurts, and other products. Whoever's right, aspartame shows negative consequences in some people. It might not be dangerous per se, but few can dispute its undesirable side effects in certain groups. Why not explore some of the natural alternatives instead? Popular choices are stevia extract, honey, agave nectar, maple syrup, and blackstrap molasses. Number 5, bottled salad dressings. You probably know that fresh salads are nutritious, easy to make, and excellent for health. But did you know that your salad dish is only as healthy as the dressing you add to it? Many bottled dressing disasters are laden with a cocktail of unhealthy ingredients. That includes sodium-rich preservatives, sugar, trans fats, excess calories, and MSG. And remember to check that label for high fructose corn syrup, or HFCS. Animal studies show that high doses of HFCS negatively affect brain performance. It can cause memory loss and affect the brain's ability to learn new things. Also, your lightweight salad can end up a high-calorie meal once you add bottled dressing. Some products have more than 140 calories per recommended serving. A healthy person would have to take a brisk walk for 39 minutes to burn off 140 calories. You don't have to rely on unhealthy bottled salad dressings to spice up your cold veggies. Consider making your own healthy vinaigrette instead, using some basic household ingredients, which are 3 tablespoons of extra virgin olive oil or other salad oil, 1 tablespoon of your favorite vinegar, and season it with a turn of ground black pepper and a pinch of kosher salt. Okay, let's move on to the next one in our list. Number 4, soy sauce. According to the World Health Organization, 2.5 million unnecessary deaths occur globally each year from high salt intake. But what's that got to do with soy sauce? Well, 1 tablespoon of this liquid condiment packs 902 milligrams of sodium. And 902 milligrams is already 38% of your recommended daily salt intake, or RDI. So how does dietary salt, sodium chloride, affect brain health? Let's see what the science says. Research from 2020 shows that a high salt diet can be harmful to brain functioning. Scientists think the likely cause is a reduction of blood flow to the brain. That can lead to cognitive decline and may eventually result in dementia. It doesn't stop there either. Too much salt in the diet can cause electrolyte imbalance and mild states of dehydration. When that happens, you may find it harder to focus on simple, everyday tasks. High sodium intake can also trigger high blood pressure or hypertension in some people. Undetected, hypertension can damage arteries and lead to heart attacks and stroke. The potential health risk implications of soy sauce go on. Consider a product like coconut aminos as a much healthier alternative to soy sauce. It's free from soy, wheat, and it contains no gluten. Oh, and coconut aminos have over 200 less sodium than soy sauce per single serving. Number 3, hydrogenated vegetable oils. Nature doesn't create harmful fats. Food factories do that. And partially hydrogenated vegetable oils, HVOs, are high on the list of dangerous foods. That's because HVOs are the primary source of dietary trans fats. The food industry introduced HVOs in the 1960s as a healthy alternative to animal fats. If only we knew then what we know now. HVOs were a dream come true for processed food producers, mostly for commercial benefits. HVOs prolonged shelf life, added texture, and saved costs. Sadly, the human cost of consuming HVOs is a different story. Trans fats can cause cell damage or death. Over time, they affect memory recall and cause brain inflammation. The World Health Organization says HVOs cause 500,000 unnecessary deaths every year from heart disease. That's why WHO urged all countries to ban trans fats and save lives. Some have, others haven't. And a few are still on the fence about it. Can you guess which foods still contain hydrogenated vegetable oils? Popular items include fried and baked goods, crackers, and coffee creamers. Others to look out for are vegetable shortening, margarine, and pre-made dough. And the list goes on. Number 2, microwave popcorn. Did you know the Peruvians were snacking on popcorn some 6,700 years ago? And today, well, it's still one of the world's favorite go-to snacks. But why is popcorn on our list of worst foods for your brain? Well, microwavable popcorn only came about in 1945, and evidence now suggests that some brands may be damaging your brain. It all has to do with a small organic substance called diacetyl. So what is diacetyl exactly? Diacetyl is a chemical flavorant added to popcorn to enhance its buttery aroma. But studies show that diacetyl also elevates amyloid plaques in the brain. Amyloid plaques are accumulations of hard, insoluble proteins. Researchers think amyloid plaques increase the risk of Alzheimer's disease and memory loss. Brain damage is not the only health danger associated with diacetyl. It's also linked to lung damage. That's because people who worked in microwave popcorn factories developed respiratory problems. While major microwave popcorn manufacturers no longer use diacetyl, some studies suggest that diacetyl substitutes may be just as harmful. If you're a popcorn lover, it's time to consider other alternatives. For instance, you can invest in an air popper and make your own healthy popcorn without the oil. Or use a covered pot and make popcorn on the stovetop. All it takes is 2 tablespoons of your favorite healthy oil for every half cup of popcorn. And that brings us to the number one worst food for your brain. Number one, ribeye steak and other red meats, when cooked as well done. Steak has an amazing chewy texture and is an excellent source of high quality protein. It's also nutrient rich with B12, iron, zinc, creatine, and more. However, it can also adversely affect brain function when cooked a certain way. But how exactly? Well, it has to do with something called gliotoxins, or advanced glycation end products, or AGEs. These are proteins with sugar attached and form mostly while cooking. And dry heat cooking of well-done red meat can elevate the level of AGEs. The Icahn School of Medicine in New York studied a high glycotoxin diet in mice. The New York study found health issues with well-done meats cooked at high temperatures. The more glycotoxins consumed, the greater the risk of developing age-related dementia. That's because glycation damage stiffens the collagen in the walls of the blood vessels. Researchers also studied gliotoxins' effect on people over 60 for 9 months. Those with higher level of gliotoxin showed more symptoms of cognitive decline. The cognitive and cancer risks linked to red meats are concerning, and the risks seem to go up when cooking at very high temperatures. So the evidence suggests that a decreased gliotoxin intake helps to reduce brain loss. But don't ditch the steak just yet. Instead, learn to love your favorite cut a little less cooked, like medium rare. And that concludes today's video. Were any of your favorite foods on the list? And now that you know what these foods are, do you plan on cutting down or find a healthy substitute instead? We'd love to hear from you, so please share your thoughts in the comments below. Also, don't forget to subscribe and hit that bell button to get instant notifications whenever we upload new videos. And before you go, claim your free gift, Brain Food Secrets, the 15 worst and best foods for your brain. Click the link in the description below to grab your copy now. You'll learn about the foods that help to optimize your brain's health. These are foods that can enhance mental focus, boost mood, ease depression, and much more. Thanks for watching. We're Brain Health Smarts, and we hope you have a fantastic brain healthy day.